Hi everyone. Well, I've got a problem. I've got too much kale. I planted this bed of kale last fall. It grew great for me all winter long, but I also have kale planted all over my garden. So I need this space here to put in a tomato plant that's going to last me hopefully into this next winter. So I'm going to take out a couple of these plants. They've gotten a little bit, well, I have to say neglected. hate to admit that, but I've been kind of busy in other parts of my garden. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this plant out and replace it with something I know I'm going to eat. And that's the whole point of this episode, is to grow what you eat and eat what you grow. I'm going to go ahead and cut this plant out, but guys, I don't think I'm going to be able to save any of it. It's looking a little buggy. I've just been busy with other parts of the garden. I'll look over the leaves a little bit later, but I'm just going to go ahead and cut the whole thing out. It's looking pretty sad and sorry over here. Oh man, there are quite a few bugs here. I don't know if they're white flies or what, but this area needs a little bit of attention. Okay, I'm just gonna get the last of these kale roots out of here and then I can plant my tomato. And guys, this area gets a lot of sun, so it really needs something heat tolerant. That's why I thought of a tomato to put in here. I'm also going to be pulling out probably some of that other kale there and planting some Malabar spinach, which several of you have suggested that to me as a really heat tolerant green. I've had a really hard time growing greens in the summertime here because, like for example, today it was around 100 degrees and you just can't really grow lettuce in 100 degree weather. So I'm going to go ahead and get these roots out here. Okay, one more little pass of the pitchfork here should do it. There we go. And let me talk a little bit about the tomato that I'm going to plant. I planted a whole bunch of backup plants, which I talked about in the last video, and this happens to be one of them. And this variety is called Bloody Butcher. It's super, super hardy. I have had Bloody Butchers in my garden the past two winters that, believe it or not, have produced all winter long in spite of some light frost. So I figured that was a good choice for this spot right here because not only will it produce for me probably late in the summer, but it will also hopefully produce for me all winter long. So I'm going to go ahead and dig a hole and get this tomato planted. Okay, let's get this tomato in the ground. This one actually already has little green tomatoes on it right here. You guys can see those. And these are, the Bloody Butcher is kind of a medium-sized tomato. If you live in a temperate climate, I'd really encourage you to get Bloody Butcher. I believe these are actually from seeds I saved from my plant that lasted me all winter. And so it's gonna be really well adapted to my backyard and the environment that we have here. And you can see this plastic pot is just completely falling apart, so. Guys, I just want to encourage you to grow what you eat and eat what you grow. I don't need this much kale. I don't even think I could use it if I froze it all, so I'm planting something else that I can use. So make sure whatever your family likes, that's what you're growing in your garden. So we're going to get this in the ground, give it some water, put a cage around it, and then we're done. I've got my tomato that will hopefully last me all winter long. All right, guys, thanks a lot for watching. That'll wrap it up for today. We'll see you guys on the next video.